Welcome to HydroSym Tutorials. This video is about the grid and the snap and ortho function. The grid in your canvas is nothing more than a digital version of squared paper. The snap function defines if you work on a grid or not. And the ortho function keeps your work aligned to the X and Y axis. Together, they'll be of great assist to keep your design clean and tidy. So let's start with the grid. As said, this is nothing more than a digital version of squared paper, only with slightly more functionality. The grid is always present, meaning you'll always be working with a grid. However, if you'd like the grid to be invisible in your canvas, you can deselect the grid's visibility here, or use short key F7. This is also where you can see what grid size is selected, even when the visibility is deselected, because then it just runs on the background. The standard grid size is 40, because most symbols are designed in this size. But you can adjust the grid size here to 80, 40, 20, and 10. And there's a dynamic setting. Then the grid size will adjust automatically to your level of zoom. The snap function defines if you work on the grid or not. Activate or deactivate it here. Or even better, use shortcut F9. If the snap function is activated, your mouse cursor moves selected elements over the grid in grid size squares only. However, if deactivated, you can move your elements freely over the canvas, over any length and in any direction. When the snap function is activated, you might like to work with your arrows. One arrow click will move you in exactly one grid-sized square over the canvas. This only works with the snap function on. When it's off, an arrow step is just very small. Now that the grid and snap function and their relation is clear, there's one more important function to explain, and that's the ortho function. It keeps your work aligned by limiting your movements to X and Y axis direction only. Activate the ortho function here, or even better, use shortcut F8. As you can see, I can move my port on the X or the Y axis only. Now if you want to move it diagonally, just deactivate the ortho function with shortcut F8 and you're good to go. Okay, let's end with some tips. This actually shouldn't happen after this tutorial, but it's possible that you find yourself in the situation that one or more elements are placed outside the grid you're working in. This happens if you deactivate the snap or ortho function and forget to activate it again. To bring them back on the grid, use the align function. Select your reference port, the one correct on the grid, then select a port that's out of line. Right-click your mouse, select the align function, in this case align Y, since we align over the Y axis, or use shortcut Y. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact our team or check the support area on the Paro website.